From Minute Maid Park in Houston, MLB The Show brings you baseball on a rainy night. It's the Chicago White Sox taking on the Houston Astros. All right, we'll be back to get this one started after this. Okay, all set to go. Here's Tim Anderson. Fouled off left side. The next offering misses, and the count is 2-2. Right-hander kicks, deals. And there's a rocket into the outfield. So a man on base to start the inning.
Seems like he got exactly what he was looking for right there. Just an awesome swing of the bat, quick hands, and just launched the baseball. 108 on the exit velocity. Man, that is coming off the bat pretty good. I know he's feeling good about it.
Verlander checks over to first, and he's back. And now it's Luis Robert. Next offering misses. Two balls and a strike. And another ball. The 3-1 comes up empty. That's strike two.
Threw that fastball right by him, slightly elevated. That's a confidence boost for this guy out there on the mound. See if he continues to climb the ladder.
And that one is lifted in the air and makes the grab. And there's one down. Jose Abreu up to hit. Anderson, the runner at first, with one gone in the inning. Anderson runs. That's in for a strike. Throw there. Safe. 1-2 now. Off the outside edge, and now the count is 2-2.
Really great change of speeds. He goes off the off speed to the fastball, and the hitter doesn't know what's coming next.
Stays alive. Next one just misses, and it's 3-2. And the pitch. Runner at second here, one gone.
Well, he's having a tough time getting a pitch by him. As a hitter, you feel pretty confident that you're seeing different pitches still able to make some type of contact.
Swing and a miss, and he chases that one in the dirt. And there's two gone following the strikeout. Here is Moncada.
Batting four. The third baseman.
First inning, and already up to 23 pitches. Line drive, and that one gets down, fair ball. Anderson flying around third. He will score, and it's 1-0. In there, just beat the tag. It's a double.
Mission accomplished there as he picks up the RBI to give him the lead. Backdoor breaking ball, and he did go the other way with it like you might think, but he put a good swing on it, squared it up nicely.
Eloy Jimenez now.
Well, lots of pitches thrown in this first inning. It's kind of that nightmare scenario for starting pitching. But you know what? It's still early enough. He can settle in. He can get some length if he just cleans up his mechanics a little bit.
Just missed his spot on the inside right there.
Yasmani Grandal up to hit. Swing and a miss. It's 2-2.
It's great to get on the board in the first frame of the ball game, but here's an opportunity for them to really open things up with a couple of runners on. Let's see if they can cash in.
The pitch. Got him swinging. Good job at damage control right there. back here in Houston. Jose Altuve up to hit here. This one lifted in the air, left field. And that one pulled down by Jimenez. And there's one away.
Good pitch. He just kind of had him out in front on that pitch away and wasn't able to stay closed.
No left fielder.
Here's Michael Brantley.
Brantley.
Next pitch misses way outside. And here it comes. Just misses with that one.
I think it's very important to establish the inside part of the plate early. Sets the tone for the rest of the game.
And that's ball four.
What a battle. It's not always easy laying off a 3-2 pitch. And I tell you what, he earned that walk.
And now it's Alex Bregman. Here's a 1-1. And a swing and a miss there. Brantley at first, one gone. Pitch misses there. Ball two. At the belt and fires. And a foul ball. He stays alive. Righty delivers.
You got a full count.
Fouled off again. And it remains 3-2. Kicks and fires. Swing and a miss. The velocity blasted it right past him. Man at first. Next is the designated hitter, Yordan Alvarez. The 2-1. Good eye right there. And a big swing and a miss.
Great RBI spot here. Just got to stay focused on the pitch. The runner will be in motion, so something in the gap should definitely score it.
Left-hand hitter waits. Tapped softly on the ground. Over to Abreu. And the inning is over. All set for the start of the inning. Now it's the right fielder, A.J. Pollock. 2-2 now. Stays alive. The 2-2 now. The punch out there, and that's the first out. So now it's the White Sox DH, Gavin Sheets. Swing and a miss, 3-2 now. Swings and misses, two gone. Josh Harrison digs in now. The wind of the pitch. Flares one into center. Dives and he can't hang on. He doesn't have a throw. He's in safely and now there's a runner at first. Tim Anderson getting ready to hit. And a pitch. Right through there for a strike. Kicks and deals. Swings through that one. It's a strikeout. That's the third out. Bottom half of inning number two. And here's the first baseman, Yuli Gurriel. 1-1 now.
He needs a quick 1-2-3 this time around. Last inning, threw a lot of pitches.
And a foul ball, he stays alive. Bounce to third. Moncada tossed to first. And Gurriel is out. And now the right fielder, Kyle Tucker.
Kind of a throwback. no batting gloves.
Next pitch is inside, 2-1.
2-1.
Left-hand batter waits. And that one is lifted in the air. Jimenez racing over to make the catch.
Every day during batting practice, these outfielders get about 10 minutes of balls in the gaps. They practice this, and when the game comes, they make the play perfectly.
The 1-1. That's a strike.
A 1-2 count. All he's seen is fastballs. You've got to expect something off speed. Stay back.
And a swing and a miss. And that's that. Back here at Minute Maid Park. Top half of the third inning. Luis Robert now. 2-1 now. Oh, now this one's blasted deep to left. Way back there, on its way and out of here. Luis Robert hits one out, and they add a run. It's 2-0. Now at the plate, Jose Abreu. He's 0-1. Swing and a ground ball out to short. Has some trouble with it, but the throw to first gets him easily, and that's the first out. Yoan Moncada steps to the plate for the White Sox. Doubled in his first AB. So, a foul ball makes it 1-2. The wind of the pitch. Swing and a foul back. That's out of play. The 1-2. Yeah, the 1-2 misses to even the count. Swing and a miss. Struck him out. And there's two away. Here's Aloy Jimenez.
Aloy Jimenez.
The pitch. Falling behind 2-1. Pitch. Got him looking. Out number three. As we go to the last of the third, and stepping in for the Astros, Jeremy Peña. So now 1-2.
This guy's got such a good sinker. As a hitter, you've got to look up in the zone. If you look down, you're going to be chasing stuff in the dirt.
Swing and a ball hammered left field. That one back there, and that ball is out of here. They're going crazy in the dugout, and they've got their first run. It's 2-1. Martin Maldonado up to hit. The wind and the pitch. 3-1, and he couldn't come up with it.
Maybe a little loss of focus on the mound right there. Pretty much gifted in first base with a quick free pass.
Here's the former MVP, Jose Altuve. Runner at first with no outs here. Next pitch misses. 2-2.
With the big bats coming up and a home run already surrendered, he's really going to have to execute against these next couple of batters.
That's out to center field. Robert right there to make the grab, and there's one down. Michael Brantley stands in.
The left fielder, number 23.
Maldonado leads off first with one away. The next pitch misses. 3-1.
3-1.
Righty to the plate. And there's the strike.
Full count.
3 balls, 2 strikes the count. Got him. And 2 away now. Here's Alex Bregman. Struck out swinging his first time.
Bregman.
1-1. There's a strike. That one inside. And the count's even at 2. Stays alive. And a pitch. Out to short. They get the force. Play made. That ends the inning. Back here in Houston. Out of the fourth. And now up to the plate, Yasmani Grandal. Here's a 1-1. Late on that fastball. And a ball and 2 strikes.
Way to lay off that fastball up right there. You're looking for something you see well that you can handle, but you also have to keep the discipline so that you're not popping up pitches that are just a little too high.
AJ Pollock at the dish. The 1-1. Swing and a miss.
1-2,
as he was out front that time. Here's a 1-2.
Ball.
In the air, pretty deep out to center field. McCormick, long run on his horse. Flashes the leather on the running catch. Out number 2. Two outs, base is empty. Now it's going to be Gavin Sheets. Went down on strikes his first time through. That's to third. Bregman to first. And that is that. And welcome back. Stepping in the long ball threat, Yordan Alvarez. And he deals.
That's a ball.
Upstairs.
Well, these guys have had a hard time scoring in this one. The guy out there on the mound wants to keep attacking, make sure that they don't get any confidence.
Counts.
The pitch. Swing, and this one's bounced to the ground. And that's just foul. 3-2. Bounce to the right side. Tosses to the pitcher covering the bag. Leadoff hitter retired in the 4th. Yuli Gurriel comes up to hit. And the right-hander deals. And a foul ball. And the righty deals.
That's the ball.
And a foul ball, he stays alive. Comes a 2-2. Stays alive. One down, base is empty. Fly ball down the line. And a base hit. So they get a man aboard with a 1-out single.
Gotta love the resiliency he showed in that at bat, battling with 2 strikes. When you pop a ball up like that, you don't expect it to get you a knock too often, but right there, somehow he got it to drop in behind first base, and that's where no one could get to it.
Hard hit, left field, base hit. Quick throw back in. Lead runner holds it 2nd with 1 gone.
That's back-to-back singles for him. Anytime you rip a line drive the other way, you feel really good about what you did at the plate. You trusted your hands. You let the ball travel.
Good feed. That's 1. On to Jose Abreu. That's 2. Welcome back. Here's the second baseman, Josh Harrison. Why to kick the pitch? And it's fouled away. The 1-2. And a foul ball. He stays alive. And that one almost got him. Right-hander kicks, deals. Cut on and miss. Struck him out. One away. And now the shortstop, Tim Anderson. A rope into right, and that's a base hit. Makes the turn and heads for second. In safely. It's a double and his second hit.
All over that one right there. When you connect and it jumps off your bat like that, you're thinking double at the very least. What a great swing on it, and man, he wasn't fooled at all.
Next to hit, Luis Robert. Next offering is down low. And a count, 2-1. And a pitch. Foul ball there. Next pitch is outside.
Hitter's got some good opposite field power. What I like about something being hit to the right side into the outfield is that the base runner at second has a very good read and can determine whether or not he can score on that base hit.
Now, Jose Abreu. Runner at second, two down. Swing and a miss. And a count, 1-2.
Clearly he was sitting on a fastball right there and just ended up out in front of the slider. Hey, you can't fault him for his commitment. Now he's just going to have to battle with two strikes.
Swing and a miss, and that is that. Back here at the ballpark, we head to the bottom of the fifth. Here's the shortstop at the plate, Jeremy Peña. Next one misses. Now two balls and a strike. Here comes a pitch. High fly ball, right field. And there's one down. At the plate is the Astros catcher, Martin Maldonado. And the pitch. Come backer to the mound. And it gets by him. So the lineup flips over. Now it's the second baseman, Jose Altuve. 1-2 now. Altuve waits. Just misses the mark outside the zone. The pitch. Roll to short, could be two. Anderson over to second, double play. And that'll do it for the inning. Back here at Minute Maid Park. All right, we go to the top half of inning number six. Now here's the cleanup hitter for the White Sox, Yoan Moncada. The pitch. And that one lifted in the air center field. McCormick makes the grab, and there's one down. Now the left fielder, Eloy Jimenez. On the ground to third, Bregman handles, gathers, and throws to first. Two quick outs to open the top of the sixth. So up next for Chicago, Yasmani Grandal. And here it comes. Check swing went around. 3-2 now. The wind of the pitch. Fouled off again. And it remains 3-2.
A little tardy on that fastball. He's going to have to get it going a little quicker. Get that front foot down.
Swing and a miss, and he is down on strikes for the third straight at bat. Bottom of the sixth inning, Michael Brantley to start things off. Left-hand hitter waits. And a foul ball. Swing and a miss, and he struck him out. Leadoff man retired in the sixth.
Now,
now it's Alex Bregman.
Alex Bregman.
Righty delivers. Stays alive. The pitch. Slapped foul.
Almost 100 pitches through 5 1/3 innings. I'm thinking he's probably done in the next couple of batters.
And he gets Bregman. That's out number two. Now it's Yordan Alvarez. He's not going to get cheated up there.
No, he's not. He's looking to do damage with every swing he takes.
Next pitch is downstairs.
Two balls, two strikes.
Kicks and fires. That one misses, and it's 3-2.
Full count.
He swings and drives one out to deep left field. That's back. And out of here. Yordan Alvarez blasts one out, and we're all square. It's 2-2.
Elevated fastballs, especially away, are like putting the ball on a tee. Hitters do a lot of cage work. They're comfortable hitting off the tees, and he was comfortable right there hitting that ball opposite field for a home run.
White Sox going with a new arm, Ronaldo Lopez. He's being eased into the game here with the bases empty.
Well, at this point in the ball game, we're talking about middle innings, and you need a little length out of this arm coming out of the bullpen. We'll see just how many outs he's able to give his skipper.
Here's Gurriel. Knocks it down. Not in time, and he reaches safely. Two outs, runner at first. Here's Kyle Tucker. Two balls, two strikes to count with two outs. And a pitch. In the air, foul off first. Abreu moving under it. Makes the catch. Inning over. Welcome back. We're in the seventh. We have a new pitcher on the mound, Phil Maton. He has a great slider with tons of movement. Here in Houston. Now it's the right fielder, A.J. Pollock. At the belt and fires. Swings here and blasts one left field. This one's got a chance. Pulls it in on the warning track. And up next for Chicago, Gavin Sheets.
Gavin.
Next offering upstairs.
Two and two.
Righty to the plate.
At this point in the game, you cannot issue free passes. He's going to have to challenge this hitter. Hitter's got to be ready to swing it.
That one lifted to left. Brantley under it. Makes the grab, and there's two gone. Josh Harrison will hit next. 1-2. Fouled off down the right side. And that one is lifted in the air. Tucker on his way over, and the inning is over. bottom of the inning. And now the center fielder, Chaz McCormick. The 1-1. Just missed. The pitch. A little bit low.
No, that's down. Ball.
The wind of the pitch. Fouls one away, and now 3-2. Is there a little wrinkle to that? I think there was.
Yeah. A little slider action.
This one popped up. Anderson sizing this one up. Great effort as he's able to haul it in. One up, one down. So digging in, Jeremy Peña. And now two balls and a strike. And he deals. Out there to center. Robert sizes this one up, makes the grab on the run. And there's two down. Digging in, Martin Maldonado. This is a guy who is very highly regarded defensively. Fun to watch him control stuff behind the plate. Good game caller, good at framing, but it's that big arm that really stands out. Two outs.
2-2.
You come into the game knowing that unless the ball's in the dirt or gets by him, we're probably not going to steal anything today.
Got him looking. And good work there as he gets a 1-2-3. New inning getting started. And the batter now, Tim Anderson. Here's a 1-1. Right side. The throw to first, and that's one away as the leadoff man is out in the eighth. Here's the center fielder, Luis Robert. The pitch.
Just not taking the bait right there, but a good pitch with two strikes.
Oh, this ball is crushed into left field. It's on its way and gone. With one swing, he quiets the crowd. He's done it again. His second homer of the game. And they jump out front. It's 3-2. One out, base is empty. And next to hit for the Sox, Jose Abreu. Kicks and deals. And it is 2-1.
Part of the order coming through now, and with one home run already in this inning, they're definitely looking to do some more damage.
Next one is off the plate. Three balls and a strike. And a pitch. There's a strike.
Good pitch to hit on a tee up in the zone. I think he was looking for something else right there.
Swing and a miss. And he's down on strikes. And there's two down. Two outs, base is empty. Now the third baseman, Yoan Moncada. 1-3. The 1-1. Swing and a miss, and he was fooled.
Good pitch right there. Tied him up on the hands. If I'm out there on the bump, I'm going right back in there.
Next offering is downstairs. Left-hand batter waits, and a foul ball, he stays alive. And the righty deals, and delivers outside.
Full count.
The right-hander gives up the two-out walk.
One of the things about that two-out walk, the base runner over at first base is going to have a very aggressive secondary lead. So a ball down the line or into the gap will produce a two-out RBI, and those are the best. That is if you are the offensive side of it.
Swing and a ball hammered left field. That one's got a chance. hauls it in on the warning track. New pitcher for the White Sox, Kyle Crick.
Number 59.
And welcome back. On to the bottom of the eighth, here's the second baseman, Jose Altuve. Yeah. 2-1 pitch is in there, and the count is even.
Well, that's really the money spot. Down and away, if you can locate that consistently, it's going to be real tough for guys to square that up. That's what you'd love to see relievers do coming out of that bullpen.
Swing and a pop-up. Foul territory for the catcher. Grandal makes the play, and there's one away.
Got the pitch that he wanted, just a little bit quick. Front shoulder open, backside collapsed a little bit, and the launch angle not where he needed it to be.
Here's a 1-2. Line to left, and it drops in, but a good job to keep it in front.
Well, that certainly feels good when you can win the at-bat after being down in the count, up against it with two strikes right there. You can't do much better than that on a pitch that far outside of the strike zone. Got him to chase on the two-strike count, but he wasn't fooled. He hit that ball really well.
Stepping in, Alex Bregman. Out towards right center field, carrying well. Turning and looking, and it's gone. Alex Bregman with a shot to the opposite field. And they add a couple more. It's 4-3. Righty reliever out of the pen, Kendall Graveman. And he'll do his best to keep this close. Here's Jordan Alvarez. Here comes a pitch. In the air, out towards right center. Robert brings it in, and there's two away. Now it's Yuli Gurriel. He's kind of an outlier, especially when guys are consciously sacrificing contact to deliver power. Back and forth we go, a seesaw battle in the late stages of this one. And a pitch. And down on strikes goes Gurriel. Third out, and that ends the frame. Jose Siri, he's out in left field getting loose there as he enters the game on defense now.
Number 26.
So here comes Ryan Pressly to the mound, and he'll feature a hard slider to work off his fastball. Back here in Houston, we go to the ninth. Now it's the White Sox catcher, Yasmani Grandal. And a pitch. Not the best swing that time from the first round pick. Tried to check his swing. Appeal to third. No swing. Just held it back there. And the right-hander deals. Got him looking. And now one away. So up next for Chicago, A.J. Pollock.
A lot of times you're looking for a guy to get that tying run on base, but because of the power, you want him to tie up the game with one swing here.
And now just two outs away. One run game here in the top of the ninth.
Definitely got the hitter conscious of the pitch inside. Really think the outer half is open.
The 3-2 is off the outside edge, and that is ball four.
They're not ready to go home quite yet.
Looks like we've got a substitution at first, and here's the pinch runner, Adam Engel. So now it's the White Sox DH, Gavin Sheets.
If you're a base runner, you've got to stay dialed in here. Look for anything in the dirt. Try your best to get into scoring position.
Runner.
Engel on the move. Pitch misses. Throw to second. He's safe. With a single base runner, because of all the power, they are dangerous to tie this thing up or take the lead. Swings and misses, and we're filled up. Swing and a high fly ball down the left field line, but looking foul. Here's a high fly ball out to center. He can't get there. It's a base hit. Around third. Relay throw. Not in time. He's safe as a run scores.
No, that at bat had a lot riding on it. Certainly a pivotal swing of the bat in this ball game. Came screaming off the bat, I'm sure. Exit velocity is off the charts. No doubt he squared that baseball up perfectly. So there was no fluke to that triple by any means.
Line drive. Siri pulls that one down, two away. Stepping in. The White Sox leadoff man, Tim Anderson. Pitch misses inside, and it's 2-2.
And that's awfully close. I don't know how you take that. He's seeing the ball out of the pitcher's hand really well right now.
Next offering misses, 3-2 now. So now two on and two outs. And the batter now, Luis Robert. Singing, you got to appreciate a guy who's this good defensively. I mean, watching him track balls in the outfield, it is beautiful. This one popped up. Foul ground, first base side. Gurriel handles the chance. And they take care of Robert for the out. And that will end the inning. Adam Engel now in the game as he comes in as a new right fielder. All set for the bottom of the ninth. And stepping in for the Astros, Kyle Tucker. Right-hander kicks, deals. And a count 1-2. One and two here. Got him looking. And they get the leadoff man in the ninth. Digging in, it's the speedy outfielder, Chaz McCormick. Got him. And now two gone. And now Jeremy Pena. He's already homered in this game. Pitch out to short, dives, but it kicks off his glove. That leaves him without a throw, and he reaches safely.
Oh, just a nice job coming through in a pretty high leverage spot right there. Just a cookie down the middle. I mean, those are the ones you dream about. Ones in the cage, you're just hoping you get in the ball game. Right down the middle, not a whole lot of velocity, right on top of it.
The 2-2. That's down and in. Fouled off again, and it remains 3-2. Mm-hmm. stays alive. Into center. Robert on the move, heading back. Back some more. Drops into the glove, and that'll do it. Oh, here we go. Pedro Baez.
The human rain delay. He's sped up this year, though.
Pedro Baez.
Welcome back on to Extra Innings. And now the first baseman, Jose Abreu. Tied at four.
You know, Boog, if you're that base runner at second base, you want to be quiet out there. Not bouncing around, not distracting your teammate, the hitter. Make sure that he can clearly focus on that pitcher and that release point.
Next pitch is outside. Right-handed reliever. And a foul ball. He stays alive. Here's the 2-2. Swing and a miss. Struck him out. And they get the leadoff man in the 10th. Here is Yoan Moncada. This is what stat nerds like myself might call a high leverage situation.
Yeah, Boog. Not sure what the numbers say, but clearly an at bat that could change the course of this game dramatically.
And a swing and a miss. And he's down on strikes for the second time today. And up next for Chicago, Eloy Jimenez. Strike three. Got him swinging. That ends the frame. White Sox going with a new arm, Jose Ruiz.
Number 66, Jose Ruiz.
Back here at Minute Maid Park. We're in extras here. Now it's the second baseman, Jose Altuve. The 2-1. Line drive, that's a base hit. Here comes the runner. Jimenez fires it to the plate. Across is the winning run. And the Astros walk it off in extra innings.
You know, he had to feel the pressure. Winning run on second base. Found a way to make solid contact. And the winning run comes across to score. Everyone going crazy. Exciting finish to this game today.
Close one here today, and your final 5-4. A one-run extra inning win for Chris Singleton and our entire crew. I'm John Ciampi saying so long.
Victorious Astros, 5 runs, 10 hits, no errors. They left 7 men on base.